before telling the name of that topic, let's discuss something interesting today. Suppose I have a cake and that cake I have to distribute into two groups, group 1 and group 2. I have to distribute that cake in equal parts into two groups, group 1 and group 2. How can I distribute that cake into two equal parts? Means half cake I can distribute, half part I give to group 1 and half cake I give to group 2. So what do you understand by the term half? Half is what? 1 by 2. Half is what? 1 by 2. This 2 represents a whole part. Whole means the entire. This 2 represents a whole part. Means the parts I have did, the parts of a cake. Total entire cake is one complete cake. First, I divide that cake into two parts. So two parts is a total parts. And this one represents a one part of total cake. One part of a total cake given to the group 1 and one part of a total cake given to the group 2. So this half we say a fraction. What we say this half? A fraction. So today's our topic is based on the topic fractions. What? Fractions. Any number, anything which represents a part of a whole. Which represents a part of a whole. Means anything which represents a whole. Means we take any part of a whole thing. That we say a fraction. Fraction can be 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 5 by 6, 7 by 8. Like these numbers we say a fraction. What we say? A fraction. Now let's take another example. I have drawn here a circle, as you can see here. Now I make a two parts of this circle, two equal parts of this circle. You can see here one part and this one is second part. Now how can I represent it in a mathematical form? Means one, if I have to represent this one part, how I represent this part is one part. How many total parts here? Two. So how I represent here? 1 by 2. I say this 1 by 2 is a fractional form. What I say? Fractional form. Now if I again make a part of this circle, how many total parts here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Total parts? 4. Now if I have to show this one part, means I shade this part, how can I show the shaded part portion? How many shaded parts are there? Only one. That where we have to write at the upside here. Now at this place which value we have to write here? The total parts. How many total parts? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 by 4th part is a shaded part. What we say? 1 by 4th part is a shaded part of this circle. So I think you understand what is a fraction. Fraction represents a part of a whole. Fraction represents a part of a whole. Now you see here, I write here like 3 by 4, 1 by 2. Now tell me one thing, what we say these values? I write here 5, 4 at a denominator place, at downside place. Now this downside place, what we call denominator? What we call denominator? And this 3 is written at upside. What we call this 3? A numerator. So the next topic is numerator and denominator. Numerator and denominator, 3 by 4. Here my numerator is 3. The value at upside we say a numerator, and the value at a downside what we say? Denominator. what we say, denominator. Now this line we say a fractional bar. What we say? Fractional bar. Now we can say fraction consists of a two things, that is numerator and denominator, and get separated by a line which we call a fractional bar. What we say? Fractional bar. Now moving on the next one, types of fractions. Types of fractions. First I have like fractions. First I have like fraction. Which type of a fraction we say a like fraction? The fraction, those fractions we say a like fraction which have a denominator same, like 1 by 8, 4 by 8, 5 by 8, 3 by 8. As you can see here, the denominator values all are same, equal. So we say these type of fractions are like fractions. Two or more fractions which have a denominator value same, denominator value equal, we say that type of fractions like fractions. Next one is the unlike fractions. In the unlike fractions, those fractions we say unlike fractions in which the denominator values are not equal, in which the denominator values are not same. 4 by 9, 3 by 5, 1 by 2, 9 by 11. Now you can see here the denominator values of all the fractions are different. So we say these all fractions are unlike fractions. Which type of fractions? Unlike fractions. Now moving on the next one, I have written here one example. Shade the given shape to show the fraction 3 by 5. Shape is this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now the given fraction is 3 by 5. I have to shade this shape by given fraction 3 by 5. As you know, the total parts we have to write here at the denominator place. Where we have to write? At the denominator place. Now we can check also how many parts of this shape. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total parts 5. Also in the given fraction, total parts we have 5 parts. Now this one number tells us the how many parts we have to shade here. This number tells how many parts we have to shade here. So this 3 gives, we have to shade 3 parts. How many parts we have to shade here? 3 parts. 1, 2 and 3. 1, 2, 3. Now you can see here how many parts I have shared here? 3 parts. So we have solved, shared the given shape. We have shared this shape by using the given fraction, which is 3 by 5. So how many parts we have shared here? 3 parts. This, if I have a fraction 4 by 8, let me clear one thing again. This denominator value tells the total parts. This denominator value is the total part, tells total parts of anything. And this upside value, which we call the numerator, this tells the part of a thing, part of a whole. This numerator value tells the part of a whole. Whole means here 8. Okay, students. Moving on the next one type, that is the unit fraction. Now you understand by the word unit. Unit means one. What? Unit means one. Now we say those fractions are the unit fractions in which the numerator value are one. In which the numerator value is 1. 1 by 11, 1 by 9 and so on. I have taken here the 4 fractions 1 by 2, 1 by 5, 1 by 11, 1 by 9. As you can see here, the numerator values are 1. So we say these type of fractions are unit fractions. What we say? Unit fractions. So okay students, we discuss about the fractions today little much. I hope you clearly understand this topic.